Undoubtedly, the most fascinating sequence of events in Carl Sagan's Contact revolves around Dr. Ellie Arroway's extraordinary journey through a series of wormholes, culminating in her encounter with advanced extraterrestrials. This pivotal part of the story unfolds with a rapid and intense pace, leaving both the reader and the central character in a state of awe. In this video, I'd like to explore Ellie's interstellar voyage from the perspective of the novel and examine some of the fascinating details of her epic journey through the cosmos. In the novel, Ellie's travel through wormhole space is made possible when she is selected as part of a group of 5 individuals to enter a copy of a machine built from extraterrestrial blueprints. These blueprints were part of a broadcast from the Vega star system, which included a sequence of prime numbers, a replay of Earth's first transmission into space, and detailed instructions for constructing an advanced machine. Once built, the machine functioned as a gateway to a cosmic transportation system, utilizing wormholes to traverse vast distances almost instantaneously. The vessel containing these passengers is a dodecahedron, a symmetrical three-dimensional geometric shape with 12 identical pentagonal faces. The machine they are dropped into possesses 3 spherical shells or benzels that must spin at critical speeds, which generates a strong electrical charge. Within the center of the machine, the air is pumped out to create the highest vacuum ever achieved on Earth. These elements combine to ensure that upon activation, a wormhole forms. The dodec is then dropped into the machine, and as it accelerates through the wormhole, the travelers experience a force similar to Earth's gravity, pressing them back into their seats with a familiar and constant push. During this journey, the once opaque interior of the dodecahedron becomes transparent, revealing the intricate and delicate network of organosilicate within, resembling lace fabric. Embedded within this lacework are small cylindrical rods made of erbium, a rare earth element known for its high-tech applications. In this case, these erbium dowels serve to reinforce the structure. As Ellie and her companions traveled through the wormhole, she observed that the tunnel walls were textured with irregular, soft-edged patterns, giving a sense of their speed. Occasionally, the dodecahedron brushed against these walls, causing flakes of an unknown material to peel off and form a cloud of fine particles trailing behind them. The tunnel seemed to undulate slightly to reduce the impact of collisions. The diffuse uniform yellow lighting illuminated the path as their vessel smoothly followed the gentle curves of the tunnel. Despite the mesmerizing sights, Ellie felt a persistent anxiety, fearing a collision or an endless fall, and she couldn't shake the feeling that she was plunging through a black hole toward a singularity. However, the expected effects of being pulled toward a black hole were not noticeable within their vessel. She then sensed a deceleration, like leveling out after a roller coaster drop and slowly climbing. The narrowing space between the dodecahedron and the tunnel walls increased her fears of getting stuck and running out of oxygen. Soon, however, the tunnel walls began rhythmically rolling, pushing the vessel forward, making her slightly motion sick. In some sections, the journey was tough, with walls contracting and expanding, while in straighter parts, their movement was smoother. Far ahead, Ellie noticed a dim point of light that gradually grew brighter, eventually flooding their vehicle with a blue-white radiance. As they surged towards the light, they suddenly emerged into ordinary space, coming face to face with a massive star that Ellie instantly identified as Vega. Contrary to her expectations, there were no planets in orbit. Instead, she saw only a few comets and a striking black hole that dominated the sky. It was an intensely dark circular field, blacker than velvet or the night sky, standing out starkly against the backdrop of the Vega ring system. The black hole's gravitational influence had cleared a broad lane in the surrounding debris rings, with both inner and outer rings giving it a wide berth. The singularity itself emitted faint, erratic flashes of light from its center, possibly Hawking radiation or remnants of Earthlight still traveling through the wormhole. Upon further examination of the surroundings, Ellie and her companions then observed a massive structure covered with radio telescopes. Soon thereafter, they began moving through a new, wider tunnel with another, much larger black hole ahead. This time, the light at the end of the tunnel was an orange glow, They emerged at considerable speed into the next system containing a contact binary where two suns were touching, with the outer layers of a swollen, elderly red giant star pouring onto the photosphere of a vigorous, middle-aged yellow dwarf. In this system, Ellie was able to identify a constellation similar to the Big Dipper and concluded they hadn't traveled more than a few hundred light years from Earth. Then the idea was proposed by one of her companions that these stops signified a closed railway of sorts, with Vega and other star systems serving as stations. At the next stop, they emerged near a variable star, where Ellie observed its changing brightness before moving on to a quintuple star system, followed by a dim brown dwarf. Each black hole they entered featured varying tunnels, some straight and others crooked. Eventually, they emerged into a sky filled with stars and an immense spiraling cloud of dust leading to another massive black hole. As they approached a structure with thousands of docking ports, Ellie realized the diversity of extraterrestrial civilizations and cultures that were present. Their vessel then aligned with a yellow-lit starfish-shaped port in this structure that appeared to perfectly match their craft. The airlock providing entry to this structure allowed only one person at a time, and when it opened, Ellie and her companions found themselves on a beach with sand, waves, palm trees, and a yellow sun. After entering, they noticed that the dodeck had vanished behind them. They then discovered a mysterious door that appeared normal from the front, but vanished when viewed from behind. One by one, her companions stepped through the door and disappeared. Shortly thereafter, Ellie spotted a figure on the beach, who she soon realized was her father, who had died when she was young. Knowing full well that it was an illusion, she was entranced by his flawless depiction, and giving in to her powerful emotions, she embraced him. Her father went on to explain they had gathered extensive data from the traveler's dreams and memories to understand humans better. Ellie then questioned the purpose of their journey and the assessment they were undergoing. He responded by reassuring her, stating the purpose was to gather information about human civilization. Despite knowing it was a simulation, Ellie felt a profound connection to this being and understood that his people were gauging humanity's potential and resilience. Ellie then asked about their transportation system, and he offered to show her and explain its function. Suddenly, an expanse of blackness obscured the sky, revealing the cosmos. They were high above the Milky Way, observing its spiral structure and the network of transit lines they had used. He went on to explain the galaxy's layout and the black holes they used as transit stations. As they explored the galaxy, he described massive black holes at its center, and how matter pulled into these singularities ended up in Cygnus A, an immense radio source. This cooperative engineering project was aimed to counteract the universe's expansion by increasing local matter density. Upon returning to the beach, she learned that the galaxy's caretakers had inherited the transit system from a long-vanished civilization. Then, after sharing a final moment of connection, she rejoined her companions and prepared to return home, carrying the knowledge and experiences of their voyage. The return trip for Ellie and her companions was filled with excitement and disbelief. As their journey slowed and the dodex panels reverted to their normal state, they felt gravity reassert itself. Ellie checked her watch, confirming they had been gone for over a day. Once the machine repressurized and the airlock doors opened, they were greeted by jubilant colleagues. However, they quickly realized a time discrepancy. Although it felt like a day had passed, the project officials revealed only 20 minutes had elapsed, leaving them puzzled by the anomaly. Additionally, all their video footage and photos had been erased, likely due to magnetic fields encountered in the wormholes. After returning to Earth, Ellie and her companions faced disbelief and skepticism about their journey. The lack of any evidence outside of light damage done to the machine led to accusations of an elaborate hoax. Government officials then blackmailed Ellie and the others into silence until more evidence could be found. Acting on a suggestion from her extraterrestrial encounter, Ellie began a project to compute the digits of pi to unprecedented lengths. She discovered a pattern in the digits that suggested a message, providing some much-needed validation of her experience. This discovery proved to be concrete evidence hinting at a deeper intelligence behind the universe, leaving Ellie with a lasting sense of wonder and a renewed belief in the possibility of future extraterrestrial contact. But I'm curious to know what you think of Dr. Arroway's journey through the universe and Carl Sagan's contact. Are there any elements of her journey or moments that stand out to you? Let me know your thoughts in the comment section below. I hope you enjoyed this video. Leave a like if you did, and be sure to subscribe for more sci-fi and fantasy news and lore. And if you're looking for other ways to show your appreciation, you can check out my Patreon page, where members get access to exclusive content and perks. Thank you all so much for your support. And as always, have a very nerdy day.